peer pressure is never okay. Ready to hear about the time my work crew bullied one of its associates? This story starts at EYF, one very slow day. All the store chores were done, and there was nothing to do. So myself, JJ, and Momemio were all at the registers partied up on Pokemon Go. We were hanging around, spinning Pokestops, catching some cool Pokemon, you know how it goes, when we all get a message in the group chat. It was from our other coworker, Jimmy. The message read, "Damn it, I'm gonna be late." Momemio and I just kind of shrugged it off and went back to Pokemon Go, but JJ was very frantically typing a reply. "Grab some BK." I paused for a moment when the notification came across my screen. Really? BK actually sounds pretty fire. But before I could even open my mouth to ask what she was doing, Momemio added, "For us." Homedog's over here really telling Jimmy to get us Burger King. Jimmy, after a small pause because he was probably driving, sends, "I'm not going to be any more late than I already am." To join in the fun, I go, "But BK, my dude." Moments before JJ continues, "Please? Bacon King." Now, Jimmy may have been getting either irritated or at least minorly annoyed because he then messages, "Next time!" in all caps. When I ain't late. Meanwhile, I'm realizing that Palmer was at home for the day, probably very confused as to what was going down in the store group chat. Sorry, Palmer. I don't think I can explain. After a few minutes of back and forth talking between the group, I muted the conversation and clocked out for a break to wander around through the nearby stores, to spin more Pokestops for the party quest that we were doing. About 15, maybe 20 minutes later, I come back to see that Jimmy had arrived to work. I say hi and curiously ask, "What, no BK?" I didn't realize the BK conversation had continued after I left the store, but something in the convo had triggered him to smack the counter and go, "Next time, goddamn!" At his remark, Momemio and JJ were both doubled over laughing. Why, I don't know. I don't get how things work. I don't understand humor. I just stood there confused, trying to figure out what was so funny. It might be the Dizzle. Turns out they just thought his reaction to my BK question was amusing, nothing major. So in the long run, we had fun. Didn't really peer pressure anyone and just had some friendly staff bickering. He did end up bringing Burger King for everyone the next day, so what's the lesson here? I guess peer pressure works, fellas. But use it sparingly. Hey there everyone, Difficult Echidna, thank you so much for watching my first ever storytime video. It was a lot of fun to make, and hopefully I can continue making silly little videos like this throughout the year. I don't know about everyone else's New Year's resolutions, but my New Year's resolution is to do more art, even if it's just these silly little videos. If you want to see more stuff from me, be sure to hit that subscribe button, and don't forget to ring the bell, otherwise you won't get the notifications. Echidna out.